Hi guys, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande.
Now that you have published the first version of the app, probably in the next version, people want another extra feature to basically maintain the place where they want to do a particular task. That means adding another column to the database table that we already have in the application. While doing the implementation, you have to make sure that you update the database structure, and the other one is, if necessary, retain the old values in the database. It all boils down to detecting the version change and then doing some operation based on that. If you observe the structure of our DB adapter, the onUpgrade method is something that we had not implemented, and this is the place where we will actually implement the versioning of the database. So let us get into a quick demo and see how this works. So if you go back to the DB adapter, I have just added few more log statements here to identify in which particular order which particular method get executed. And when I install the application for the very first time on the device and then observe the logs, the first method is onConfigure and then of course onCreate. And now if I change the version of the database, we maintain constant called as DB version, I will change it to 2. And now if I rerun this, just observe what happens. OnConfigure, onCreate did not get executed, but onUpgrade got executed. Whenever the database version changes, the onUpgrade method comes into picture. So if you are trying to change the structure of the database whenever app version changes, the onUpgrade method is the method that you need to write the new functionality of modifying the structure of the database or the table. If the person is directly installing DB version 2 app, then create table to do should contain the another column also. So let me define another column here, column place. This needs to be added to create table statement. So we are done with the create table to do, and in the on create, that particular table will get created. And if the database version changes, then the onUpgrade method implementation comes into picture. And in this particular method, you need to alter the table. So to alter based on the old version, you have to basically execute certain set of statements here. Let me do a switch on the old version. So if case is 1, SQLite database dot execute SQL alter table, the name of the table is table to do, add column, the name of the column is column place, and it is a text data type, and that's it. Now we will have to modify the insert method. So let me create a overloaded method of insert, which takes another string value, which is a place value, and I will add that to the content values dot put column place place, and this needs to be invoked in place of UI, that is main activity. And here I need to pass the another edit text value which will capture the place. So I will have to modify the UI here. Let me add another edit text. Let me go back to the activity, create another edit text. Let me initialize it, add to do, and the second parameter is edit text place dot get text dot to string. In the get all to do's, I need to capture another value which is a place. For that, I need to even update to do bean class. So I will have another private string place attribute. I will have another parameterized constructor which takes place as one of the argument. So this dot place is equal to place, and add getter and setter for the place. And going back to the adapter, another argument dot get string. Here in the main activity, I will have to update it to display the place, and the place should be fine. And I think we are done with this. The bean class has been modified. The DB adapter has been modified. Now we have to pass the column place as the third column that you need to fetch. So we are done with all the necessary changes. So if you go back to the application, this is the older version of the application where we have only the ID and the to do. So let me add another value here. To bring in the new database changes, let me go back to the to do here adapter and change the version here to 2 and run this. You will observe that for the third column here, we are getting null values because we didn't have the values for these three already pre-existing entries. So we will now add a new value into the database. The value would be tell boss about new version, and the place you want to tell it from is desk, and let me add it. As you can see here, we are able to add the values successfully into the modified structure of the database. With this video, I basically end the discussion of SQLite database and managing SQLite database in an Android application.
That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.